This video is an introduction to evolution. Let's start with what people believed long before Charles Darwin ever arrived on the scene. Ancient Greek philosophers like Aristotle believed species were fixed and unchanging. Many people also turned to the Old Testament, which asserts that species were designed by God and therefore perfect and also unchanging. Even thousands of years later in the 1700s, when science was booming, there was an assumption that the match of organisms to their environment was a sign of design. Even the famous Carlos Linnaeus, who is famous for collecting thousands and thousands of organisms and developed a naming system to reclassify life, believed this. However, the consensus that life was unchanging was beginning to break. Scientists in the 1700s and 1800s had begun finding bones of animals that were extinct or were drastically different in size compared to animals seen alive. Also, geologists of that same time period were beginning to propose that changes to the Earth were slow and gradual over centuries and ages, longer than people had thought the Earth was supposed to exist. So the stage was really being set. Creeping into people's minds were these questions about whether life forms in fact do change over time, and if the Earth itself was quite old and itself changing. Along comes Frenchman JeanBaptiste Lamarck, who made some major waves in scientific publications of our time. Who, you might ask? You may remember learning about Lamarck's theory of evolution from his famous giraffe example. A giraffe with a short neck reaches his whole life to get to leaves on higher branches. And because he was able to stretch out his neck a bit in his own life, his offspring would have a longer neck. Remember that guy? Well, this idea of being able to inherit acquired traits is one of Lamarck's most famous ideas, even if in the end it turned out not to be accurate. Traits you acquire in your life are not passed down to your offspring. A weightlifter doesn't have stronger babies. However, Lamarck made several really important contributions to biology. He was one of the first to propose that the environment might cause animals to change or adapt. For example, a black bear population, should they experience the onset of an ice age, may, over time in many generations, change their fur to be more camouflaged. He also thought the toothiness or lack of teeth of an animal may be due to changes they experienced in food availability over time and over many generations. Great ideas! So while Lamarck wasn't the first to mention ideas of animal change over time, he can be credited as putting together one of the earliest and comprehensive theories of evolution based on these main points. Life on Earth is indeed evolving. Forces are driving life to become more and more complex. Life adapts to its environment. Use it or lose it. Now, Lamarck didn't actually use that frame, use it or lose it, but just like he had the giraffe stretching his neck and being able to pass on a longer neck to its offspring, he also had this idea that if there's something you have and you don't use it, eventually over time it gets smaller and smaller and may even disappear. So in general, Lamarck had this theory that acquired traits are heritable and you can pass those on. So this was his comprehensive, inaccurate theory of evolution. Lots of good ideas here, though. So along comes English-born Charles Darwin, who even as a young boy seemed fascinated with biology, taxidermy, and botany. He took a stab at following in his father's footsteps in medicine before dropping out of medical school disinterested. And then he disappointed his father yet again when he dropped out of studies to become a clergyman, again disinterested. Eventually, in 1831, he found his way on the HMS Beagle as a naturalist to keep the captain company as he charted the coastline of South America. It was along this voyage that Darwin noticed some strange phenomena, such as seashell fossils in rocks that were well above sea level, sometimes even very high in mountainous cliffs. He also saw some fossils that remarkably were similar to living creatures but with significant differences, like the size of the extinct megatherium on the left compared to a living but related sloth on the right. He also noticed slight variations among related organisms in different habitats, especially the related finches on different islands of the Galapagos. Some birds clearly had beaks big enough for nutcracking, while others were small and thin enough to reach into tree bark and find insects. So Darwin established his own theory of evolution, and we call that the theory of natural selection. and it was based on 4 observations. Variation exists. Members of a population differ from each other quite substantially. Inheritance. Darwin realized that the differences that you see, this variation that you see, was heritable from parent to offspring. Darwin also noticed overpopulation or overproduction. Populations produce more offspring than the environment can support, so there's always a struggle for existence. And this led to his 4th observation, differential reproductive success. Better adapted individuals survive to reproduce more offspring. Those that inherit traits good for surviving and reproducing are able to produce more offspring. This unequal ability alters the frequency of traits that end up in the next generation and leads to an accumulation of favorable traits in the future generations, and that's how populations change over time. This led Darwin to postulate that all life descended from a single organism, and that as that organism reproduced, its offspring would vary, those varied offspring would spread out and encounter new habitats, and certain variants would survive better than other variants. This theory can be characterized by the phrase descent with modification. These principles have now been rigorously examined and tested and have been shown to be true. The organisms most fit to an environment pass on their traits successfully. This, over time, combined with the new arrival of variants through mutation, has led us to the rich diversity of life that's on Earth today. Let's do a quick review. Which was the prevailing theory prior to Darwin? Pause it if you don't have it, because I'm about to give the answer. The answer is B. Earth is a few thousand years old, and populations are exactly as they have always been. This was the prevailing theory. True or false, Darwin was the first person to propose that evolution occurs. Pause it if you don't know it, I'm going to give away the answer. That's false. Don't forget JeanBaptiste Lamarck and those giraffes. Other people came up with theories of evolution before Darwin did, but Darwin had the most accurate answer that's persisted through time. Finally, which statement about natural selection is most correct? Pause it if you need more time before I give away the answer. The answer is D. Well-adapted individuals leave more offspring and thus contribute more to the next generation's gene pool than poorly adapted individuals. Okay, that's all. I hope you enjoyed this introduction to evolution, and we look forward to discussing these concepts more with you in class.